sia lodato Gesù Cristo. È la sesta domenica di Pasqua.
Sixth Sunday of Easter. Psych B. 9th May 2021. The Gospel takes us to the upper room. Let us imagine ourselves there and fix our gaze on Jesus. Jesus senses an atmosphere of incomprehension, of distance, of betrayal. He sees human history with its abysses of hatred and corruption and endless violence. It is the history that we all know well and experience every day. Jesus, if he had been like us, would have had to say to the apostles, "Go away, all of you. You are my disappointment. You are God's disappointment. You don't deserve anything anymore." But God doesn't act this way. Jesus, in fact, feeling the heavy climate of hatred growing around him, that would then be unleashed at the hour of the Passion, launches his challenge. The challenge of love, the challenge of goodness, and he says without hesitation, "This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you." We would be tempted to say, "Lord, if we leave this commandment, will we not become too weak? Will we not expose ourselves to the onslaught of wickedness? Will we not be defeated by the evil that seems so strong, so aggressive, and so arrogant?" But Jesus' thought is clear. It is unequivocal. Let us try to take a look inside the centuries of Christian history to see what happens when we leave this commandment. Few years ago, on October 11th, 2009, the Holy Father Benedict XVI declared Damiano de Vosta a saint. Who was he? He was a Belgian priest who left as a missionary for the then unknown and remote islands of Hawaiian archipelago. In 1873, when Father Damian was 33 years old, the bishop of the Hawaiian Islands told his priest, "In our diocese, there is an abandoned island, an island where no one has the courage to go to bring the gospel. It is the island of Molokai, the island that gathers all the lepers of archipelago. Who feels like going to bring the love of Christ to that island?" Father Damian de Vosta got up and told the bishop, "I am ready. I'm available to go to Molokai." Molokai was a hell. Bad brain, alcoholism, violence, and every form of morality dominated there. When Father Damian arrived on the island, they asked him, "What are you bringing? Money, food, clothes, medicines?" Father Damian replied, "These things will come, but first, I want to put joy in your hearts." They asked him, "How?" Father Damian confided his plan. "I want to put peace in your hearts with prayer, with charity, and with the forgiveness of sins." He was mocked. He was reviled without scruple and without respect. However, after 10 years of charity and goodness, the island of Molokai changed. Father Damian truly brought joy to the hearts of lepers, teaching them the commandment of charity and the beauty of goodness. Molokai became a paradise of goodness. The commandment of Jesus bore its prodigious fruits. Father Damian died a leper, saying, "I am the happiest missionary in the whole world." Let us come closer to us. Year 1964, Marcello Candia, a rich industrialist from Milan, sells his carbonic acid factories and leaves for Brazil to make an investment in charity. He believes in the words of Jesus, believes in the fatal force of the commandment of charity, and wants to bring some works of mercy in a very poor area of Brazil. He builds a hospital where the poor have priority admission. He builds a leper colony for 800 sick people. He builds several houses for handicapped people without families. He builds a school for nurses and two cloistered monasteries to support the works of charity with prayer. In 1980, when John Paul II visited this marvelous city of love in Marituba, a leper with no hands, feet, or nose, named Adolucho Galado, greeted the Pope and said, "Holy Father, we are no longer in despair because the brother has told us concretely that God loves us too." Wonderful victory of Christ, the commandment of love. A leper colony is filled with joy and hope because a Christian decides to live the commandment of charity. Jesus once again was right. March 13, 2005. John Paul II is seriously ill. He has lost the use of voice. He, who was an exceptional communicator, he has lost the ability to move. He, who was a tireless worker. March 30, 2005 is Wednesday, and the Pope knows that many people will gather for usual audience. He did not want to disappoint the people and therefore let himself be accompanied to the window to offer a greeting and give a blessing. The Pope is visibly marked by suffering. He is imprisoned by the illness which inexorably advances. But his heart is free. His heart vibrates with love. And without uttering a word, he makes a tiring sign of cross, which is the last blessing to the world. It is his silent testament of love. In that gesture, it became clear to everyone that the Pope was spending the last crumbs of his strength, and he was spending them to transform them into acts of love, in acts of goodness. The world understood and was moved. What happened in the days that followed was the emotional response of humanity before the prodigy of commandment of charity lived to the extreme sign, as Jesus taught us. I remember a man who came to venerate the mortal remains of John Paul II on display in St. Peter's Basilica, approached me and said in my ear, "I had lost my faith, but I found it again by looking at the faith of that man. I have come to say thank you." And the young man added, "I'm 24 years old, but I feel old in my heart." Instead, he was young. And he pointed at the Pope. Once again, the power of charity prevailed over the jungle of human selfishness. Now Jesus is waiting for a response. Let us not be overcome by wickedness, for the love for the power of wickedness is only apparent. Let us reduce our goodness and submerge evil with our good works. Let us hasten, for time is short and there is still much good to be done.
Sia lodato Gesù Cristo.